Hey there, it's Elina, your friend, the nuclear physicist, and today we're doing something new. We are reviewing memes. Memes that have to do with nuclear physics, nuclear engineering, and nuclear power in general. And we're gonna have some fun. Hopefully, we are going to understand what the memes are about and trying to explain, see if they're accurate, if they're not, if they make sense or not. To my favorite memes, I'm going to be giving the friendly nuclear physicist thumb of approval. So without further ado, let's get into it. Can anyone tell me why can't I take a decent picture of this cinnamon stick? Come on, this must be fake. And must be, hopefully it's fake for her own sake. And it's, I mean, it says danger radiation and it has a radiation sign on it. Come on now. What does it say? Drop and run. It actually writes drop and run. I see cobalt sign and I'm assuming Curie, so it says how much the activity is. And the white pixels, right, is the one that we had mentioned when I was reacting to the Kyle Hill video. So, of course, the gamma radiation that is emitted through this radioactive material, which I hope is fake, is interfering with the lens of the camera, the pixels, and so on. That's why you wouldn't be able to take, let's say, a decent picture of it if it's emitting gamma radiation. But for the love of God, I think and hope this is fake. I mean, it's not wrong, right? Not totally wrong. Yeah, I can see it. I can see all the hype about the renewables and all the greenery and all the nice stuff. But then again, the crop itself is very tiny. However, nuclear maybe doesn't really look that impressive, doesn't really sound that appealing, but then the crop is substantial and the energy that's produced is like many, many times larger than the one of renewables. I see it. The first friendly nuclear physicist stamp of approval goes to this meme. I like this. This meme I like. I mean, this meme is not really a meme either, right? It's like almost reality without the small fun there. Yeah, I get it. That the renewables don't always produce energy when the, let's say, weather is not in the ideal conditions. So you have a nuclear power plant working a fan that's being powered by the nuclear power plant that turns around the wind turbine. I like this one. I like it not so much because it, let's say, puts down the work that the renewables are doing, but I like it for the fact that the radiation sign is actually on the containment building and not on the cooling tower for once. And for this reason alone, I'm giving this the friendly stamp of approval. Marie Curie, all I want for Christmas is you. U-235, this is a good one. I mean, this is actually, you know, matches with the season and the holiday vibe in general. I like it. I think it's quite funny. Not always quite accurate though, because for example, if you have the Canadian CANTU reactors, they use natural uranium. So there you would want uranium-238. And yeah, with different kinds of fuel in the future, maybe you would want something else and that wouldn't match anymore. But I like it. I like the idea. It's clever. Using Chernobyl as an example to argue about the safety of modern nuclear power plants. Tell me about it. It's like using this as an example to argue about the safety of modern airplanes. Yep, this is exactly the case. And I have already said that in videos in the past and generally when I do have conversations with other people that bring up Chernobyl as an argument against the safety of the current reactors is that the aviation industry also had several severe accidents that resulted in many deaths, more deaths than the nuclear industry had in total because of its accidents. But nobody nowadays takes a plane or goes to take a flight to go somewhere and think that their plane might probably crash. Otherwise, nobody would be flying. And people are flying all the time. So this same misconception and this kind of negative perception that we have about nuclear energy has to change and should not be defined based on an accident that happened 30 years ago and is not the one that is driving the way that the industry is working nowadays. Okay, wind and solar. Okay, and she's using that too, shutting down fossil fuel plants. I guess is trying to show that it's doing nothing. Wind and solar, it's not going to shut down the fossil fuel plants, and that's true, by themselves alone, they're not sufficient to produce the same amount of energy, let alone the same consistency as the coal plants. And yeah, that's why you would need nuclear there. Nuclear power, anti-nuclear activism, why can't we fix climate change? Well, also quite accurate. I mean, if you are an activist, right, an environmental activist, then you cannot be anti-nuclear, in my opinion. You have to be educated and understand the benefits that the nuclear industry can bring to the countries that use nuclear power, it makes no sense nowadays, in 2022, in the era we live in, to talk about CO2-free, fossil fuel-free energy production without including nuclear power in the mix. I would never be a simp. And then Marie Curie, at your service, my queen. Well. Okay. I mean, it's Marie Curie, right? She got two Nobel Prizes. She was the first female to ever be awarded a Nobel Prize and the first person among all the scientists, male as well, to be given two Nobel Prizes in two different fields, one in physics and one in chemistry. Okay, 2018, Germany is like a puff dog. Let's build wind turbines around coal mines. Yes. 2022, we need to expand the coal mines. I mean, poor dog is crying here. They're not wrong. They are not wrong. And, you know, we all know we have already done this discussion about Germany. They made things too rashly. They decided to shut down all the reactors without really having a plan for the future, thinking that renewables are going to solve the solution. And alone in the nowadays, they can't. They can't really. And there is no answer to that, at least for the foreseeable future, short term. So they should have thought it through. I agree with this one. A radioactive spill. This is amazing. This is amazing. This is amazing. I like this one very much. This is, of course, because bananas have potassium inside, and potassium is an actually radioactive element. Its levels of radioactivity are not that high, and of course, that's why we can eat bananas, and nothing will ever happen from, let's say, eating bananas in terms of radioactivity. So it's very, very funny how they say a radioactive spill. This definitely takes the friendly stamp of approval. It is actually funny to mention that when I was back in my graduate studies, we actually did a project of measuring the natural occurring radioactivity of bananas and determining how many bananas a person would need to eat to get a lethal dose from radioactivity. And we concluded that it would be around 1 billion of bananas that one would need to eat in order for the radioactivity level to be so high to actually be lethal. And of course, the conclusion was that one would die much earlier from many different reasons that are not associated to radioactivity without even ever reaching the limit to exceed the lethal dose of radioactivity. Hydrogen, wind turbines, geothermal, marine energy, solar, they're all watching oil, gas, and coal do the work by hand. Whereas then we have a big truck that says nuclear. I've been told to stand here since 1945. That's a good one, because if nuclear gets there, you can see the difference in the amount of power that can be contributed to the energy production. So yeah, I like this one. This is a clever one. It gets the message across. I give this my friendly stamp of approval. Pro-fossil fuel, anti-nuclear energy activists, 1972, we don't have time to build reactors, 82, we don't have time, 92, 2002, 2012, 2022. That's right, meanwhile, reactors have been built around the world, especially in China. They were built with very rapid pace and even faster than they were built back in the days, which, yes, evidently took a long time, but still, they are here and they are working. So every time, providing the same argument for a time span of, 50 years? You would have built a lot of reactors in 50 years' time. Hey, watch where you're throwing that neutron. And they're playing with the neutron. What? And then they're throwing it and there's an explosion. That is cute. That is funny. They threw it maybe at a supposedly, let's say, uranium atom that captured it and created fission. Wouldn't say it's that accurate, because you would need these kids to throw a lot of neutrons for, let's say, an explosion to happen or something like that. But very funny nonetheless. It needs a little bit of background information to understand it. Germany builds wind turbines and closes nuclear plants over tsunamis or some wind. Slows down a little. Germans. It's actually interesting how countries that got so much affected about the accident in Fukushima, which was caused because of tsunami, not because of a malfunction of the reactor or because of a poor, let's say, maintenance of the power plant or design, nothing of that sort. Countries that are, let's say, deciding after that to shut down the reactors and not use nuclear anymore, like Germany, are the ones that don't have the same kind of, let's say, fears. They don't have the same geographical disposition or area that Japan has or are located in the same areas. They are not prone to tsunamis. Germany is not even surrounded by water. So there is no such danger that would cause the reactors in Germany to experience similar, let's say, accidents. And it really puzzles me and baffles me how these people took such strong-hearted decision by an accident that, yes, was scary and, yes, did cause, let's say, nuclear accident, even though the first, let's say, initial reason of the accident was not nuclear, but it was environmental. But nonetheless, doesn't affect your country, Germany. Who would win? All the waste from 45 years of Swiss nuclear power plant or one fast spectrum reactor? Boy, I guess and hope that the boy will win. Well, the idea here, I guess, is that you can build types of reactors that actually use as fuel the spent fuel of the Generation 3 reactors that we currently have and from which we're currently getting the spent radioactive fuel from. So, of course, this is the bigger goal and the biggest, let's say, idea that will partially and to a very big extent solve the problem that the nuclear is facing, the major problem, which is the management and the disposal of the high-level radioactive nuclear waste. Greens rejecting nuclear power and then the ocean temperature rising. Yep, same here. I absolutely agree with this meme. That is the whole point, that if you are an environmental activist, and especially if you have a strong voice like Greenpeace and these kind of organizations, you have the obligation to be informed, because people believe in these organizations, they think they are here for the best, they're here to protect the environment and humans alike. And without an informed, let's say, opinion, these organizations are typically biased. And they don't really give all the necessary information to the public, so the public can make an informed decision about the energy that they want and how they want it to be produced in their countries. Me discussing the benefits of nuclear power and how pathetic wind and solar is. The door-to-door solar salesman. I hope the door-to-door salesman is not like that, because they should have the information necessary to defend solar when there is a place to defend it, and to understand its limitations when there is a place to understand the limitations. Close the pipelines, stop the nuclear power plants, launch the energy transition, and then nothing, just blackness. Okay, I get that. If you are trying to get, as we said, fossil free, and you are trying to not use nuclear, it's gonna be a tough game. And I'm not sure if one is going to win that game. Actually, I'm pretty sure they're not. And we've seen that from Germany. This was fun reviewing these memes. They were really funny. A lot of them were pretty accurate. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought about this meme review and if you would like me to review even more memes in the future. It's been Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and until next time, see you soon.